Thank you. Today's show is about the growing concern for crime within the jewelry district, located right here in the heart of downtown Los Angeles. From Hill Street to Broadway, between 5th and 8th Street, this is the largest jewelry district in the United States, reporting an annual sales of over $3 billion. I'm Valerie Allais, and today our focus is on the risks that these salesmen face each day. Joining us after the break is Federal Agent Robert Thornton, an expert in jewelry-related crimes.
Does it ever wear on you? The job? Because I've risked everything this past 6 months. Sometimes it's just not worth it being undercover.
Yeah, but that's just how things go sometimes. Just wait till we bring these guys in. You'll see. Things always work out in the end.
Hand me the rest. Brad, give me the rest. That makes it $3 million, right? Looks like we're in the wrong profession, boss.
Welcome back to Allais in LA. Joining us now, we have Federal Agent Robert Thornton. Thank you for joining us.
It's my pleasure.
First off, can you describe to us why this area is so dangerous for jewelers?
Yes, I will. Los Angeles has an extremely high level of foot traffic. And it's these circumstances of overpopulation that make it very difficult to try to put together forces to combat these crimes.
So what you're saying is, although these forces are in place, any individual can still become
a target. Give me your phone.
Exactly. The men and women that we're talking about generally work alone, and they'll carry large quantities of assorted jewelry, and especially cash.
What is the range in value that any one of these salesmen may have on a typical business day?
Well, it varies. I mean, we've had cases involving amounts from $250,000 on up to over $3 million.
That's serious money.
These are serious crooks.
What happens if we don't get these guys today? We go back under for another six?
We get our asses handed to us by Thornton.
It's amazing how fast you can gather information nowadays. Literally
and
right
yes.
Out of the air around us.
You probably go back on. Fill the case.
Phillips, I need my life back.
You're a cop. You don't have a life. You have 20 minutes. 7th and Hill.
And that's what makes them so vulnerable?
Yes. And that's why it's so important that they take all necessary precautions before coming into downtown.
Well, I hope this has been helpful for any of those involved in this business. Thank you again for joining us, Agent Thornton.
It's my pleasure, Valerie.
I'm Valerie, and thank you for watching Allais in LA.
Thank you.
running, everyone. Today is the day we spent the past 6 months preparing for. Victor and Alec Thomas, they are our target. By the end of today, they will be in our custody. Tiara, are we locked on satellite?
Yes, sir. Both signals are strong, and we're still waiting on a visual confirmation from Edwards.
Edwards, what's your position?
Northwest corner of Grand. No visual on Gray yet.
At his first mark.
I'm pulling in southwest of him now.
Where are people?
Brad's inside, position one.
Good morning. What do you have for us today?
Whatever you need.
Edwards, any sign of a
suspect?
No, we haven't seen him yet.
Tiara, take watch for me.
Sir?
How about 100,000? 7th right now. I'm on my way, okay?
Oh! Ow! Frank!
Fuck!
Damn!
Oh, your suit, man. Let me see.
I'm fine.
Just let me see your suit.
I'm all right.
I'm okay.
Are you sure?
Really? It's fine. I'm okay. I'm all right.
Fine.
They got away. They pulled him into the alley.
Drive.
We're blocked in.
Tunnel. We don't see him. That's there. Black 06 Monte Carlo. North on Hill over the 101. They're just ahead crossing the
tip. Be advised. Suspects are armed and considered dangerous. Use caution on your approach.
Suspects ditched the trackers. We lost them.
You really hit me.
You said, make it believable.
Not a bad day's work, gentlemen. Wasn't it worth the wait?
Absolutely.
What the hell is this?
This is what we took from you.
Hey,
who the hell do you think I am?
All clear, sir.
Looks like things didn't work out in the end after all. Not for you, at least.
The case. It's empty.
We switched it. What? You didn't think I'd catch on? Thought you were smarter than that. You get some attention and look what happens.
Phillips.
There's nothing I can do for you now. You should have come to me first.
Didn't get pride. Open up the window, see the lick. ran into a chick, coffee, spilling it on him, she feeling on him. I just witnessed this witch, say flipping it on him. He didn't even notice, somebody got the case with the stone. Two armed men, how about the money, Carlo? Now he's catching punches, getting jacked in the alley. They got the wrong black case, about to catch a case. Agents from the scene, see I told you fools it wasn't safe. Wait, noise in the next room. Sounds like a walkie-talkie. They lost the briefcase. The boys was here. We next door to where they had the thing.
Okay, uncuff me.
Salam, welcome to our home. Thank you for joining us for Rosh Hashanah. Everybody have a healthy, happy, and prosperous New Year. Thank you very much from the two of us.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay.
Safa, we'll serve you the wine. We get started because I know you're very hungry, right?
Yeah. Yes.
So hungry.
Let's start with the wine, sweetie. Yes. Okay. Sarah Maranam.
Hi.
Baruch Ata Adonai, Elohim Melech Haolam, Borei Pri Hagefen.
Hi.
I don't understand. Why can't you tell me just now? But I don't want to wait for the letter. You're looking at my file. You can tell me if I was approved or not. Sure. I'll hold.
So, what are we doing today?
Today, my friend, we gamble.
I found this group of bozos. Rich bunch of guys. We're gonna clean up big.
Gamble?
Yeah.
With what money? My kids' diaper money? Or your wife's medication money?
How about Slava's money?
Slava? As in King Vladislav?
Yeah.
As in Russian loan shark Slava?
Uh-huh.
All right, I think you've had enough of this for a while.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Look, it's taken care of.
What do you mean it's taken care of? Are you crazy?
Look, his guy's gonna be here any minute now, so just, you know, relax. Well,
oh God,
you can count me out, buddy.
You really want to borrow money from that maniac to gamble? You've heard the stories. It's just not smart.
Look, I told you, I sniffed these guys out. I asked them if they play, what their game is. You play hold'em, they're like, huh, what, whatever. Trust me, it's gonna be easy money.
Not worth it.
Oh, my friend, привет!
So you must be Jimmy. Is there a problem, Jimmy?
No problem. No problem at all.
Great, Slava's waiting, let's go. You heard the man.
Great.
Slava's waiting, let's go.
Slava.
Fuck.
Slava.
So you want the $20,000?
Yeah. You know I do.
The juice is dirty. Just a little something to make it sweet for me.
Isn't that sweet enough already?
Any problems?
No. We'll take it.
Give them the money. And get them out of here.
Get out.
Come on, Slava, man. Don't do this to me. I got you, man. Trust me, man.
Thank you for your recent application. A request for child adoption was carefully considered. We regret to inform you we are unable to approve your application at this time.
Check.
Check. All righty. Two big fellas.
Thousand.
Let's make it three.
Call.
Call. Boat.
Quads.
Goddamn.
Nice move.
Forgot to tell you guys. I'm pretty good at hold'em.
Yeah, man. Betting wise, you're just gonna have to be smarter next time.
You said this was gonna be fucking easy. You said it would be pizza cake.
I think you're overreacting.
Man, they play hold'em.
They told me that they couldn't.
We're fucked.
We're not fucked.
We're gonna lose everything.
We're not gonna lose everything. Look, man, you have to focus. Jimmy, I know that we can do this. You know that we can do this. Focus, and we're solid.
All right. Just deal the cards.
Any problems, gentlemen?
No problem.
Let's play.
What do you think?
So?
So?
What do you think?
So?
Not so bad for sitting around on your ass for a couple hours, huh?
Yeah, you're lucky I almost fucking killed you back there.
Kill daddy, love daddy. Oh, daddy. Oh, daddy. So how much we got?
We got Slava's money.
plus his juice, and five for each of us.
Me.
All right.
Hey, we better grab a cab and get this stuff to Slava before he expects it at midnight, you know? I don't want to be walking around with all this cash.
Domino! Gracias, cabrón! Thanks for the favor, homies! Pendejo!
Where have you been all day?
I fucked up now.
What's going on? You're scaring me.
We went gambling and me and Brad, we borrowed money from this maniac and now Brad's...
What?
We lost the money and now this man is gonna come here. I gotta come up with
$26,000. $26,000?
Fucking Brad got me into this.
$26,000?
Look, it's gonna be okay, okay? We're just gonna go away for a while. We're gonna go out of the country.
What? Where?
As far away as we possibly can.
With this baby? Are you crazy?
Well, it'll only be for a little bit. I mean, it's only 10...
No, Jimmy!
What are you doing here? Why are you packing?
I already talked to my parents. I'm gonna live with them for a while. I'm leaving you, Jim. And I'm taking him with me.
No! He's my baby! He's my boy! You are not going to take him away from me. Now you listen to me. If you love him, get ready, pull yourself together, and let's go!
No, Jimmy, please, you can't do this! You can't!
Listen to me. Listen to me. I have no other choice. They will find us. They will come here. And they will pack up. We're going right now. We're going away for a while. Okay? I'm going to get the tickets and I'll be back. I'm going to be right back in a half an hour. Be ready when I get back. All right? We are leaving, with or without you.
Jimmy, please, no.
Wait, I'll take you the money. I got it.
All right? Jimmy, don't play around.
Okay.
Get the money.
All right. I'll take you the money. Okay. All right.
Put him in the car. This is game. If you don't have Slava's money, I kill your whole fucking family.
Hey, man, it's fucking jammed, okay?
Come on, boy.
Hey, little guy. Hey, let's not wake mommy now, okay? You have fun with grandma and grandpa? Good. Okay, we're gonna go for a little ride. Okay.
Gonna get you all in.
Commanded Abraham to sacrifice Isaac. And as he was about to sacrifice his only child, God said, stop. And as for Sarah, some say she heard the news and died of shock. Some say she died of natural causes. But some say she committed suicide, and as she jumped from the mountain, her screams could be heard for miles.
אשר קדשנו במסותו וסיוונו, תשמע כל שופר.
אמן. תריעה. תריעה של תדלת. שוורים. תריעה. תריעה של תדלת. תרועה.
Hi, Senora. Senora, I'm Jimmy Gray. I'm your neighbor from across the street. You know, mi esposa, Melissa. Melissa, you went to you go to the laundromat together, okay? You do laundry, you know, Melissa. I have to leave my baby with you for una hora.
Sir, I don't know you again.
No, it's también. It's okay. Just one una hora, okay? Just,
no puedo.
No, it's okay. It's all una hora. I'll be
Pero
right back.
Pero me tengo que ir a trabajar.
No, it's okay. It's all right. Just 1 hour.
Get on your knees.
Slava, man. I'll get you your money, man. I'll get you your money. Man, look. I'll do anything you need. It's not me, man. It's not me.
Are you looking for these?
A pretty boy. Oh, not so pretty anymore.
No, Slava, listen, I have a kid. I have a baby. I have a little boy. Okay. Come on, man. I'll do anything you want. Anything.
Pasando a otras noticias, esta noche la policía encontró el cuerpo de un hombre asesinado. Su nombre es James Gray. Él era el esposo de Melissa Gray, quien hace unos días falleció en un fatídico accidente de automóvil. Este joven matrimonio tenía una pequeña hija, la cual se encuentra desaparecida. La policía investiga su paradero. Cualquier persona que tenga información, llamar a la policía o a...
Thank you.
Yeah, they have it here.
Shut up! It's not supposed to be out yet.
No, it's just the demo they have on display.
Is there a release date?
Let me check. It says later this month.
Buy it.
I think it's your turn. I bought us the new console last time.
True, but I bought that discount memory card with you. You know that even if I bought one first, you would get one eventually.
I guess.
I'm broke. You need to buy it so that our lives will have purpose.
Joel, come in here for a moment.
Yeah.
We need to talk about college stuff with you.
Mom, I haven't even started my senior year yet. It's way too soon to even start thinking about this stuff.
Well, you're running out of options, so we might as well talk about it now. The way we see it, you'll be going to the state college down the street.
Well, I thought my grades were good enough to get me in most of the schools we talked about. I thought I was going to CSU.
Your grades are fine, and they better stay that way. But we just can't afford to pay for you to live on campus. Apparently, they're all willing to waive their tuition, but none of them is willing to dish out anything for housing.
So I'm stuck at home for college.
That's not that bad, honey. You can walk to class in the morning. Just give it a try. We just can't afford to pay for anything extra.
Speaking of money, that game system I was telling you guys about, the Venatus, it's coming out in a few weeks, and I was hoping you could lend me some money.
Joe, if you want to buy more video games, you're going to have to get a job. We just can't afford to buy you any more video games. Go get a job.
Yeah, well, my parents don't have any money either, so no dice.
Well, you need to figure something out. This is the most important thing that will ever happen to us. Look, I can't talk right now. I'm installing a portcullis on my back door.
Okay. Later. I will find a way.
Ray, I'm gonna be able to get the Venatus.
Did you steal something?
No, better. I'm gonna get a job. My uncle, he works at the zoo, and I'm sure he can get me something. By the time school starts, I should have the Venatus.
Joe?
Yeah.
I'm Steve. You must be the new guy they suckered in shit detail. I mean, petting zoo area thing, area.
Yeah,
whatever.
Yeah, well, they said I could move up in other areas once new positions opened up, so
yeah?
I figured.
That's cute. They told me the same thing when I started 18 years ago. Look, there's a shovel, a rake, another rake. Grab the rakes and the shovel, put them in the bucket. Let's go that way. Let's see if you can figure that one out.
Yeah, I got it.
It's pretty simple. I think someone like you could even figure it out. See these turds? On the ground? All these?
Yeah.
Take the rake, rake them up. Every single little pile, get them all. Bunch them up, do what you gotta do. I don't care, just get them off the ground.
Okay.
Magic. Very magical.
What, in one pile or what?
In all of them, just scrape them all up. It's good.
Oh
yeah, that's llama shit. Gets in your shoes, smells bad, girls don't want to go out with you. This is the life, you know? This is what we do, you know? You gotta clean up all this shit, feed these little bastards 5 times a day, and list of rules on the wall, you know? People are not allowed to do certain things, you need to enforce that. And yeah, clean up the barn that they sleep in. Pretty much good to go.
Is that everything?
Sounds like everything. And if you need anything, I'm gonna be in the rainforest exhibit right over there. You come get me.
Wait, you're leaving?
Anything. Yes.
No, wait.
Move, shall be, whatever you are.
Missed a spot. Oh, no sex with the animals.
What is that?
Oh, it's pachyderm poop. Yeah, it smells the worst.
It's huge. I mean, yeah, elephants are big, I know, but this is like a pile of basketballs.
I know, mate. I've been working here every day. Speaking of work,
I should be getting back.
No,
you
no.
Should too.
Wait, can you help me? You're the new guy, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, don't worry. It's not nearly as bad as Steve likes to make it out to be. You just like seeing how much you new guys can take.
How many people have quit this job?
Oh, hundreds. Probably even thousands. People are quitting every day. You want to be pushing around that stuff? But come on. Some kid could be chasing around a goat or something.
Okay. Thanks.
Smell you from here. I just changed your sheets, so don't lay down until after you've showered and changed, okay?
Okay.
Carrie, are you Joe?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, of course you are. They said you were cute. I work here on the weekends. You started last week, right?
Yeah, last week.
Cool. All right, well, let's get started, I guess. Let's get it over with.
Sure. This isn't really as hectic as I thought it would be.
Yeah, pretty much the only trick to it is just to make sure that you scoop it up really quickly before they get scared. Okay. If they're not scared, they'll just do it all in a pile, but mm-hmm. if they're scared, they're gonna run and spread it everywhere, and that always sucks. Hey! What the hell do you think you're doing? No, look, it clearly says on that sign right there that you cannot climb on our animal friends. So get out before I have you thrown out. Idiots, always.
You really like these animals, don't you?
Not really. Well, clearly I like animals or I wouldn't work here, but mostly I just like to yell at people when they're stupid.
She's so amazing. I think I'm falling in love, Ray. I just can't wait to see her tomorrow.
You don't think she could give us the money for the supervenitus, do you?
What? You know, I knew I shouldn't have talked to you about this.
Look, I'm just saying that women are expensive.
Yeah, I know.
I guess, having known you for 10 years now, I'm not worried. The day you spend money on a girl over a video game, I'll know something's wrong.
Okay, I'm going to bed. I'll talk to you later.
You know, you think it's gonna be different when you get to college. You think that suddenly there's going to be nothing but smart, wealthy men that all want your number.
What, you mean by next year I'm not going to be smart and wealthy?
Okay, don't patronize me. No, it's just I met this guy that I could have a decent conversation with, and he hasn't called me.
Oh. Well, how long have you been waiting for the call?
Like 3 weeks.
Well, I wouldn't know too much about that, but sounds like a lost cause to me.
Maybe all of it's a lost cause. Mm-hmm. Now, why wasn't there anyone like you when I was in high school? Oh, honey, look at that.
Oh, they're so adorable.
Porcupines?
Yeah.
Okay, what happened during your childhood that would make you like porcupines?
I don't know. I just always thought they were cool. What about you?
I like penguins. Actually, when I was really little, I used to think that if it got cold enough to snow, that some penguins might show up on my front porch.
How old were you when you found out penguins wouldn't migrate to your house?
I don't know, but I was definitely disappointed.
Sometimes learning stuff just sucks.
Yeah, it does. You said that you go to Pacific, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I start my second year in a few weeks.
Do you like it? I mean, what's it like going to private college?
I like it. I mean, you know, the campus is nice, dorms are nice. I wish it was closer to town, but...
How much are the dorms there?
I actually don't know. When I was really little, my grandpa died and left all this money to me and my cousins, so I don't really have to pay for tuition or books.
Oh, God, that's really great.
Yeah.
Well, not about your grandpa, obviously. I'm sorry.
Well, I was like two, so yeah. It's not a...
Oh my God, here, check it out.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, shit! Oh, shit! Get the...
Oh my God, it is the little things in life.
It is. No, you see, it's just like I told you. I'm just gonna find the few little things that make your job worth going to.
Yeah, I think I know what you mean.
You should really hang on to this job, Joe.
Yeah, because all the ladies will love my exciting stories of relocating fecal matter.
Okay, well, not if you word it like that. I mean, there are things about this job that you're not gonna like, but you get that with any job. I mean, at least here, by just walking from the petting zoo to the exit at the end of your shift, you're seeing, like, a million things that other people have to pay $10 to see.
Okay, yeah, that's true. But there's just so much crap.
Well,
I mean,
then...
it's not really a glamorous job.
I mean, it's just cost versus benefits. Is this job worth it to you? I mean, I know I wouldn't want you to quit. You waiting for me?
Yeah, I wanted to talk to you, actually.
What? Well, I have to go in a minute, so hurry.
Oh, okay, well, I wanted to give you this.
Oh my God! That is so cute! Thank you!
Do you like it?
Clearly.
Good.
This is so cool.
Yeah. It's got...
Joe, go wash your face.
What? Why?
No, just... You've been handling crap all day, so hurry.
Okay. I'm glad you're concerned for my personal hygiene, but I'm really kind of a clean guy.
Thanks for the
penguin. Whoa. Yeah.
I'll see you next weekend.
Yeah.
you had a social break. Maybe we could talk more the next time you
come. Oh, yeah, it was nice to meet you.
There.
I like your room.
Thanks.
You do not have a spot set aside for that gaming system.
Yeah, you need to plan ahead, man. Carrie, will you go out with me?
I can't. I mean, I would like to, but I can't. Joe, I'm not gonna be working at the zoo anymore. I mean, I start school next week and I can't come across town every weekend to work at the zoo. I mean, I can't come across town for anything. It wouldn't work.
Yeah, you too.
So, it's my last day. Well, what do you say we finish this up and do something fun?
Yeah, sure.
Let's go.
Hey. Go where?
Well, Joe, they might never let you out of this petting zoo, but before I leave, it's my job to make sure you see at least a few cool things. So take these.
Okay.
And let's go.
Okay. Sorry, bad joke, I know. Had to do it. So when do you leave again?
Tomorrow. Oh, I brought a picture. I mean, it's stupid, but you can have it.
No, it's not stupid at all. I like it.
So you should call me a lot.
Yeah. Carrie, I think I'm in love with you.
I know.
Sounds, but if we could both.
Yeah,
make it...
but you're just too young for me.
What? How could you even say that? It makes no sense at all. I just feel.
I'm sorry.
Joe, you need to fill out those papers. They need to be turned in soon. I want them tomorrow morning.
Okay. Okay. Do we really need 8 controllers, Ray?
Are you really asking me that? Don't forget the network package.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I got that. What else?
Oh, do they have any of those chairs with the speakers?
Come on, game chairs? Yeah, of course. Didn't even think about that one.
Okay.
He's gonna pay, so one second. Sorry, dude, I forgot you were there.
What, did you get it?
Oh, the Venetus? No. Sorry. I'm gonna work weekends until next summer. I gotta save my money, man.
What? Why?
Have you seen the dorms at Pacific? They're expensive, Ray.
I really enjoy being kind of the underdog, because with my voice, with this band, with the talents that we have, we shouldn't be able to do what we do. My mom and my dad didn't exactly like each other very much. When I was 5, my parents got divorced. So my mom and my stepfather, we started bouncing around the country, and I saw my dad once a year. But bouncing around the country, I kind of developed this this longing for dad. I didn't know that much about my dad. My mom just kind of kept me sheltered, very sheltered. The world was just kind of closing in on me. So when I had the opportunity to grow into manhood, I moved back to Texas and quickly found out that the Lord wasn't a part of my dad's life. And it also happens that in the world that he was in, there's drug use and stuff like that that can mess with your mind. Before long, I found myself kind of at odds with my dad. I spent a lot of time, man, just scared. Everything that I kind of dreamed of was kind of not there. My mom called me up. She said, "Jason, if you'll come out here to North Carolina, we'll pay your way to NC State." And I was like, you know what? That sounds like a great option, a new lease on life. About that time, I kind of caught the bug for real music, you know. I moved out and I was playing my guitar on the beach all the time, hanging out with people and writing songs to express what was going on with my dad and what was going on with my mom and how they were at odds. So I started a band. It was my release. It was the one thing in my life that I decided on my own I was going to do. And there was a lot of resistance to it. My parents at one point said, "Okay, well, Jason, you can either go to NC State or you can play in your band." It really made me think hard about, am I serious about this? Am I not? I also came to the conclusion that I was going to continue school and I was going to continue playing. My parents kicked me out of the house and I was on my own. I went to college for one more semester. I was playing basketball and I got assaulted on the courts. My face got really messed up. I woke up in an ambulance and it ended it for me. I walked away from it and I said, that's it. It's ministry, it's music, that's it. That's all I'm gonna do the rest of my life because life is short, it goes away. I never saw anything coming. I woke up in an ambulance. I'm lucky to still be alive. You know, God just orchestrated this masterpiece in my life. And the whole time, I thought my life was just falling apart. You know, through my life and through seeing everything fall apart and watching God still move in amazing ways, I can walk on the stage and be confident. It didn't even matter if we became a signed band. What mattered was that we were changing lives. And in small quantities, yes, but to us, that was all that mattered. We were at the Dove Awards the other day when we won New Artist of the Year. My grandfather, who's an amazing man of the Lord, he looked down at the stage and he saw Scotty wearing his pants all, you know, torn up. And he's like, I just don't like that. My mom, who, you know, asked me to leave, told my granddad, she said, you know, they had 350 people saved at one of their concerts the other day. She looked at my grandfather and said, when was the last time you had a Southern Gospel concert where 350 kids showed up? To me, that meant a lot, you know, because it meant my mom understood. I've seen my music change my dad. He's the biggest fan on the planet, knows every word, every song. I'll be having a rough day and I'll call him, he'll quote the lyrics to my songs to me, reminding me. My little boy is 2 years old and he's starting to sing the words to the songs, says Daddy when he hears it on the radio. My son can't even hardly talk yet, but when he starts talking, he's gonna be speaking lyrics to talk about the glory of God. How many other kids out there has that happened with? But more than that, it's happened with my son. I've got a lot to work on, but I'm not gonna let him down. I refuse to. It's been a long road to get here, you know what I mean? So, I gotta go get ready.
Date is July 7th, 2008, 9:30 a.m. So tell me what happened.
I told you, it was never supposed to open.
What was never supposed to open?
The elevator.
We checked the elevator. It hasn't worked, let alone open for years.
Wait, what do you think? You think we're all just lying to you? Check it again.
I didn't say that, but you gotta start telling me something I can work with. Stop with this ghost elevator.
I'm telling you the truth.
Come on, kid, just stop it.
It's true. There is something in the elevator.
Thank you.
Sneaking into school on a Saturday is so dumb. Why are we here?
Well, if it's true, I'm not gonna miss it.
Black folks are crazy as hell. I heard Krista is gonna go in if it opens.
The letter. That's why white people always be dying in scary movies. They always gotta investigate. Killers be like, come here. And they just walk right to it, being like, where are you?
This is so stupid. Why are we even here? I don't know, but let's put a leg out. I think we should just, like, go in.
I'm like, gosh.
I don't know if this is going to work out. I don't know what's going on.
This is a joke. You think that thing is going to open?
You know what? Brian, what exactly is the myth about this elevator?
Honestly, Rebecca, I don't know. But I did hear that supposedly every 7 years, on the seventh day of the seventh month, at 7 a.m., it opens. What could that possibly mean?
It better.
Do you think something's in the elevator?
All right, guys. Guys, it's 6:59. Get ready. 5, 4. 3, 2, 1.
I guess I was right. I told you it wasn't gonna open.
I didn't think it was really gonna open.
Well, guys, it looks like it was a waste of time waking up this early.
I'm gonna fucking kill Dominic! So you think you're funny, Dominic? I'm gonna kick your ass! Dominic? Guys? This isn't funny! Jessica? Is anyone there? Oh man, I'm losing it.
Oh.
Tell me my name! I'll set you free!
Glenn!
Not! You're trapped in forever! And your soul belongs to me!
Do you want to play a game?
Okay, wait.
Someone.
Are you playing the game?
Who are you?
Are you playing the game? Are you playing the damn game?
Yes!
Fuck!
Wait. Hey! Wait.
Do you know what you just did? You fucked us both.
Please, tell me what's going on.
You didn't have to play the game. After 7 minutes, the elevator would have taken you back, and now you're stuck here until you figure out that bastard's name, just like me. If you'd have faced your fears for 7 minutes, it would have taken you back, and I could have piggybacked the hell up with you. There is no way I could spend another 7 years in this fucking hellhole.
If all we have to do is figure out his name, then let's just figure out his name.
You don't listen very well, do you? I have been here for 7 years. Slowly, meanwhile, my fears have been eating me alive this whole time. And you don't think I would have thought of that?
Well, if the elevator's gonna work in 7 minutes, let's just wait in there.
Yeah, that's great, sure. Till he comes back and drags you away, we have to stay on the constant move. You understand? The moment you stop and you're doing nothing, that's when your fears can attack. Come with me. I want to show you something.
What is this?
Since I've been here, I've been in search of this creature's name. I was able to find these articles of notes left behind by people that have fallen victim to this thing. They date as far back as 1952.
That's 7 years after the school was first founded.
Yeah, but this article says right here that before this was a school, it was actually a board game factory owned by a famous board game designer by the name of Robert Cowell. He was being sued by the president of some small ice company who says he stole his first game idea. The case fell flat soon after due to lack of evidence, but Robert Cowell was killed in that elevator, and that's when the factory shut down.
Well, that's it. Robert Cowell. That's gotta be his name.
No, that's not it. I've tried, man.
Well, this here says that two police officers were investigating the mysterious death. When they arrived at the scene of the crime, they had found him in the elevator, and it seemed he had hung himself by a rope from the ceiling. Mm-hmm. But there was no chair or stool that the man may have jumped off. The only clue that was left was a puddle of water. So how did he die?
See, that's the thing, man. I can't figure it out for the life of me. I'm sure once we do, it'll lead us to his name.
What was the name of his first war game?
What was it? Rubble Stiltskin.
How much time do we have?
I don't know. I don't know, man, but no more than 5 minutes.
Somehow, everything is connected.
Oh my God.
Hey, what's wrong with you, man? No! No!
ちなみに高専戦隊をケミシ金が陸海将兵の優先金が百両有志の。
今の聞いたか。
陛下の言葉ですね。
航空隊に帰還命令が出た。
また飛行機の故障ですか。
今朝の第二陣の出撃も中止になったみたいだ。
あなたの任務はどうなるのです。
泉、俺たちは最後の一兵となるまで戦い抜かないといけない。これが本当に陛下のお言葉だと思うか。
公式発表なのでしょう。
民が直接陛下のお言葉を賜ることはないはずだ。
でも大本営からのお言葉ですし。
一体何があったんだ。
陛下は何と。
実方針は順の赴くところ耐え難きを耐え忍び難きを忍びもって万世のために太平洋百貫と押す。
戦争が終わったんだ。Lisa, is everything okay?
Things can take time.
You're leaving in 2 weeks.
Then I guess I have my work cut out for me, don't I?
You're being serious, Peter.
I'll be back in 4 months.
Yeah, if you come back.
What?
Maybe. Oh. I'm sorry.
Jesus, I mean, why would you say something like that?
Every time you're away, I hold my breath when someone just knocks on the door.
I'm an engineer, not a soldier. I mean, I don't even carry a gun, for Christ's sake.
Yeah, that's really reassuring.
Did I come back last time?
Yeah, but what if you don't come back this time?
You know what? What if I get killed driving to the post office this afternoon?
What
if I get hit by a car backing out of the driveway?
Peter, stop it!
I'm gonna come back!
I'm scared, okay? I don't want to be left alone.
What do you want me to do?
I need assurance.
You know, I can't.
I need to get pregnant.
The 機関隊が沖縄に接近している。
規模は
10隻だ。可愛い子だな。名前は
桜です。
この子が大きくなって父親の最後の話を聞けばさぞ誇りに思うだろう。
日本は
降伏したのではないのですか。
停戦命令は出ておない。
陛下はそうおっしゃっています。
それは側近どもの考えで、陛下が真に意図されていることではない。我々は決して降伏はしない。
この上さらに10ヶ月も馬鹿げた攻撃を続けるおつもりですか。
貴様、ウラク司令官を愚弄するつもりか。
泉、やめなさい。
司令官は祖国への忠誠心でもって出撃なさるのだ。
宇垣司令官は操縦の経験が終わりにならないのでは。
しかし貴様はそうではなかろう。
あなた、お許しになってください。
行かせてくれ。
So the official surrender was signed on September 2nd on board which vessel?Anyone? All right, well, don't forget that your reports are due on Monday. All right? Have a good weekend.
Are you still comfortable?
I am so cool, he no deny caol, ya sakura no gotoku.
Anata, お願いです。行かないでください。
泉、どうか晴れ晴れと送り出してくれ。これは名ある詩なんだ。
私にはただの犬死にとしか思えません。
これは戦争なんだ。
戦争はアメリカが広島で終わらせました。
分かってくれ。これは俺の兵士としての務めなんだ。
あなたの父親としての務めはどうなのです。
安国を訪ねてくれ。俺はこれからずっとそこにいる。
それがあなたの定めだというのですか。
俺は天国で親父に会うだろう。そしていつかお前と桜にも会えるよ。
その時まであなたなしで耐えろとおっしゃるのですか。
今ならさよならと言っておくれ。
Lisa Green?
No. No, don't say anything.
I'm so sorry.
No, don't you fucking say anything.
I'm so sorry.
No. No.
No!
How's my baby?
She's healthy. And beautiful.
I don't think I can do this alone.
Can I tell you about my father?
ために策、総力を将来の建設に傾け。